Hello all, welcome to Rad's Kitchen. Today I will show you how to make the famous Chennai style vada curry recipe. In this video I've used air fryer to make the masala vadas and instant pot to make the curry. Before we get started, support us by subscribing our channel and hit the bell button for new video notifications. Soak the chana dal for at least 3 to 4 hours. Now grind this dal along with some red chilies and salt. Make sure to completely drain the water before grinding and make this as a coarse mixture. Now let's add these items to the dal mixture. Let's add the curry leaves, finely chopped onions, green chilies and fennel seeds to the dal mixture and give a good mix. Let's set the air fryer to preheat at 370 Fahrenheit for 15 minutes. In the meantime, let's spray some oil and brush it all over on the grill pans or the air fryer basket. Now let's make the patties with the dal mixture and keep it on the oil sprayed grill pan. Poke the vadas with fork to get it cooked evenly. This is optional, and spray some oil. Now let's place the grill pans in the preheated oven. When it indicates to flip the food, spray some oil and change the racks. I would say 12 minutes is enough, but if you want little more brown and crunchy, you can keep it few more minutes. Now you see the vadas are crispy outside and cooked thoroughly inside too. Now I'll make the vadas into small pieces for the curry. Put the instant pot in saute mode, add some oil. Now let's coarsely ground the whole spices and add it along with a bay leaf. Add the onions and green chilies and saute for a few minutes. Once the onions are slightly browned, add the ginger garlic paste and give it another couple of minutes. Now let's add the spice powders, turmeric powder, Kashmiri chili powder, coriander and garam masala powder and give a good mix. Now I'm adding the roughly crushed tomatoes. Saute the tomatoes until it forms a nice gravy consistency. Now add 2 cups of water to thin it out. Add some salt. Now I'm going to grind 1/4 cup of shredded coconut with some water to add this to the gravy, and add some mint or pudina leaves. Once the gravy starts to slightly boil, add the vada pieces and give it few more minutes. Turn off the instant pot and let the vadas soak for some time. This might absorb some water, so I suggest you to add enough water to maintain the gravy consistency. Garnish it with some coriander leaves before you serve the vada curry. It pairs nicely with set dosa or idli or puris or chapati. We have this vada curry as a Saturday special breakfast with some puris. Hope you like this video and subscribe our channel to watch more interesting recipes, and leave a comment or share if you like this video.